चलते चलते में आपका स्वागत है। मैं हूं शेखर गुप्ता, बम्बई के वर्ली सी फेस पर। और यदि मैं आपको बोलता कि मेरे आज के मेहमान एक ऐसी हस्ती हैं जिन्होंने बहुत साल आतंकवाद का मुकाबला किया, दो बार मौत को बिल्कुल अपने सामने देखा, एक बार दो गोलियां खाई, एक बार उनकी पत्नी ने भी एक गोली खाई, तो आप एकदम बोल देंगे कि उनका नाम जूलियो रिबेरो है। जूलियो रिबेरो साहब, चलते चलते में आपका स्वागत है।
शुक्रिया।
आपको याद है पहली बार तो मैं आपके साथ नहीं था जलंधर में?
हाँ जी।
लेकिन दूसरी बार हुआ रोमानिया में, बुखारेस्ट में।
जो आप आए थे और यहाँ से आप अकेले जर्नलिस्ट इंडिया से जो आए मुझे मिलने के लिए, आपका मैं कभी भूल नहीं जाऊंगा।
नहीं नहीं, लेकिन आपने जो कुछ किया उसको कौन भूल सकता है देश के लिए। बट सर, यू फॉट टेररिस्ट, इट्स वेरी स्ट्रेंज नाउ दैट द सेम पीपल हु आर नाउ हेलिंग यू एज अ ग्रेट voice for Indian liberalism, they used to then call you this tyrant, bullet for bullet tyrant, who was bumping off terrorists.
Well, I don't know whether I bumped off any terrorists. As far as I know, I never bumped off anyone. But we had to do a job.
Right.
And the job was given to me. A lot of people asked me why I accepted it.
Right.
Because nobody could have forced me to go there.
Right.
Because, you know, I was allotted to the state of Maharashtra.
Right, absolutely.
And I could, and the, only the center has a lien on me, but not any other state. So it had to be with my consent.
But you had enough name and fame in Maharashtra already. You did not have to go to Punjab to get more fame.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I policed my own city, the city where I was born.
Right.
And where my ancestor to up to fourth generation. I'm the fourth generation of the family born in Bombay.
Yes.
My great grandfather came from Goa to settle here.
Right. So, sir, when you took the job in Punjab, and then you finished it. Now it's been more than 3 decades since you finished it.
Yes.
About that much.
Yeah.
Do you have regrets over what you did or how it was done?
Not really, though. I did feel at the start that a whole community was suspicious about me and felt that I had come to kill them or to beat them. I don't know what they felt I was trying to do, but I had no such intention, because the people from that community who were indulging in terrorism, well, even they should have been fighting that. They did it at the end.
Right.
At the end, towards the end, they did it.
Punjab police fought in the end.
Punjab police fought ever since I landed there. They had no problem about fighting. But I'm talking about the general Sikh population.
Right, right.
Because they don't understand the nature of terrorism. And when they really understood it, they themselves turned against the terrorists.
They fought back. But sir, the line you used, bullet for bullet,
That
defined that fight. Do you now have any regrets having used that line, or you think that is the way terrorism should be
fought? You know, I've been saying it from the very first day that I did not say those words, but it were put later on. They were used. If you read Mr. Pradhan's book, who was the Union Home Secretary,
R.D. Pradhan.
R.D. Pradhan, he said that the person who actually invented that was Mr. Arun Nehru. And I didn't know exactly till I read his book that it was he.
But it has got attached to your name.
But the Hindus were so pleased, or so, not pleased, but their morale rose so high with that I said, no, let it be. Huh. Let them say that I have said it.
So you did not deny it?
No, I didn't. In the beginning, I did, particularly with Mr. Barnala.
Right.
He was quite upset. So I told him I did not say it. It is not in my nature to take revenge on anyone.
Right.
But I did say that we'll defend ourselves, because you know how this came about. The journalist came to meet me after 7 policemen had been shot dead to rescue one man, to rescue just one man, a man called Sukha Sipahi, who was formerly a policeman, and 7 of them were killed. So then they asked me, what are you going to do? I said, I'm going to teach them to fight back.
Right.
That is what I said.
And you lost one of your very able officers also, who worked with you personally.
Absolutely, Mr. Avinder Brar.
Right.
He was an
IPS officer, athlete.
Athlete. He was a swimmer. Who represented India.
Right.
He was also a amateur pilot.
Right.
You know that.
Right.
He was a person of.
And he was just jogging when he was.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. He took an unnecessary risk. That was a misfortune.
Right. Yeah. So those were angry days. Sir, I'm deliberately going back to Punjab.
Yes.
Because there is a method to fighting terrorism.
Yeah.
It has to be a tough method. India has evolved its own way over the years. But terrorism has now become complicated. You can no longer say Sikh terrorist, Muslim terrorist, Hindu terrorist. So while it's wrong to say terrorism has no religion, if you do terrorism in the name of religion, it has religion. But you can't now blame one religion.
You know, there were only two kinds of terrorism in the past. Now we have got the jihadi form, which is
right.
Goes beyond boundaries. But formerly, there was only the the leftist,
right?
One, the Naxalite. Ideological one,
Maoist, yes.
Which happened in even in Germany with right. The Biden Meinhof gang,
yes.
And the Brigatisti Rosa in Italy. But you had the nationalist form in Ireland.
Right.
For 200 years, they were fighting the British. And there was religion to a minor extent because one was Catholics and but actually it was more economic than anything
right.
Else.
Right, Protestant, yes.
Yeah. The classical form of combating this terrorism is to go after those who are not going to reform. I mean, you have to go after them like Mr. Gill did in
Punjab.
But you have also to win the hearts and minds of the general
other, yes.
Population,
yes.
Of the community to which the terrorist belongs. And that is perhaps more important.
Right.
And when that was done in Punjab, terrorism ended there.
And that's why you could use Punjab police against terrorists.
Well, Punjab police, they are Jat Sikhs mostly. They fight whether
it became Jat Sikh versus Jat Sikh.
Whether they fight on that side or this side, but they fight. They are a fighter. They are a fighting people. And I tell you, I had no problems with them from day one.
Right.
No problems at all.